In this video, I am going to show you how to set up raylib on your Windows computer and use it with C++ and Sublime Text. This procedure is very easy and it won't take us more than 5 minutes. So, let's start at once. First, we are going to download raylib. We have to visit this website and click the download button here. You can donate if you want to support the developer of the library, but you can also download the library without donating. Now we have to download the raylib 4.5 Windows installer with the MinCW compiler. When we run the downloaded file, we get a warning from Windows. Click More Info and Run Anyway to start the installation. By default, raylib is installed in the C drive. If you don't want to modify any files later, don't change the default installation folder. After the installation is complete, in your C drive, you are going to find a raylib folder where all the required files are located. This folder also includes a compiler and a debugger, so we don't need to install them separately. Next, we have to visit my GitHub repository to download a template C++ project that uses the raylib library. This sample project will help you get started quickly. I have included all of the required C++ files and settings, including those for the compiler and Sublime Text. If you find this repository helpful, please give it a star so that more people can learn about it and save time when setting up raylib with Sublime Text. Now we need to extract the .zip file to our desktop. We can use this folder as a starting point for every new raylib project. Everything is already set up and ready to use. Next, we will open Sublime Text and we will load the template project in it. We can either drag and drop the folder we just downloaded onto the Sublime Text window or select File, Open Folder and select the folder. On the left side of the window, we can see all the files in the template folder. When we double-click on a file, it opens in a new tab. To run the main.cpp file, which creates a simple bouncing ball example using raylib, click on it. Before we can run it, we need to configure how Sublime Text should build our project. To configure Sublime Text to build our project, we have to go to Tools, Build System, and select Create New Build System. This will create a new build file. Now we have to copy all the contents of this file, the raylib-cpp.sublime build file, and paste them into the new build file. Now we need to save the file as raylib-cpp.sublime-build. Next, we close both tabs and we go to Tools, Build System to verify that raylib-cpp is selected as our build system. If it is not, we select it manually. Now we can press Ctrl plus B to build and run the bouncing ball example. It was easy, wasn't it? You only need to create a new build file the first time you set up Sublime Text to work with raylib on your computer. To create a new raylib project, simply copy the template folder and select the raylib-cpp build file to build your project. If you want to learn more about raylib, please subscribe to my channel. I will post more tutorials on this fantastic library. I have already created detailed tutorials on the snake game and the Tetris game using raylib. These tutorials will teach you all the basic in just a few minutes. Click here now to watch them and learn. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.